am here to introduce the speakers for this breakout session. And it's an absolute honor and pleasure for me to do that. Because these two members, these two directors, are very close to my heart because they have been doing amazing things in their region and for BNI India over the past more than 5 years. Santhosh Radhakrishnan is a successful entrepreneur and a business coach, and is helping entrepreneurs to scale their business. He's leading currently a team of 200 plus members with branches across multiple cities in India and abroad. He is also into event marketing, customized stall designing and execution for trades. The other speaker, his partner in BNI, Muhammad Nassar, is a co-founder and director of E2E Excite Marketing and Training Services Private Limited, providing services like brand activation, event marketing, customized stall designing and different types of trade fairs. I'm not going to talk much about their personal life. I would like to talk more about what they are doing for BNI India and for their region. They are the co-executive directors for the region BNI Coimbatore. They presently have more than 600 members in their region. Over the last 5 years, they have 13 chapters and 680 plus members with average chapter size of 52 plus. And the region has done business of 1750 crores in Indian rupees over the last 5 plus years. One of the highest business generating region of BNI India. They have also come up with the theme-based chapters. One of their chapters is predominantly of the industrial and manufacturing sector. Another chapter, theme-based chapter they launched, was all members are catering to the requirements of the agriculture sector. So they have trend setters for BNI in more ways than one. Santhosh is also a part of BNI India's national training team for the Model 2 training. He's also the district director for BNI India and has coached more than 17 regions in the last 18 months. So without much ado, I would invite these two gentlemen who over the period of the last 5 years have consistently had the level of retention in excess to 80%. Today with 680 plus members, the retention level in the region is 83%. So to understand how they have been doing it, it's my honor, pleasure and privilege to invite Santhosh and Nassar. Good morning, BNI.
Good morning.
Thank you, Atul Bhai, for the wonderful introduction. We would like to start with that food, like we are here today because late Shri Bharat Bhai of Hyderabad. Thank you, Bharat Bhai, for putting us in BNI. And we also have to thank our mentor, Puri Srinivasan, who has helped us, and what we are doing today is only because of his mentoring. And we have been fascinated by the leadership of Matt. It was like compelling leadership for all of us. So thank Matt and Puri for their wonderful leadership. And we are proud member of BNI One India family. This particular family has something very close to our heart because this family always gives and are always engaged in the culture of learning. And thank you, BNI India One family, for all the coaching and inspiration you have given us from the day one. Thank you so much. What we are today is because of your fair coaching. Thank you so much. And it is our pleasure and privilege to present the formula for retention.
Good morning. Good morning. If we don't give attention to retention, we'll be in tension. If we don't give attention to retention, we'll be in tension. Ladies and gentlemen, what we're going to present in this presentation is about what is retention, why retention, why do members join BNI, what is the triple E formula, how to greet, how to engage, how members make more money. If I have to ask you to remember three words when you leave this particular hall, it will be three powerful words: greet, engage, and money.
If you ask us how to calculate retention, seriously, you know. And for the last 5 years, we have not tried to find out what is that. But what we know is a company can seize extraordinary opportunities. They are good in ordinary operation. This is what is very close to our heart. Like, you can definitely seize extraordinary opportunities if it is you are good in ordinary operations.
And that is a wonderful word for Brazilian entrepreneur.
Ladies and gentlemen, if you want to go to the next level in your role, if you want to climb up your organizations to the next level, do you want to know the secret what you need to do? Love? Yeah. The secret is very, very simple. All you need to do is do an exceptional role in whatever current role that you're doing. Do an exceptional work and you'll be able to really go to the next level. So what Santhosh has just said is about the operational efficiency of the current activity that you're doing. I want to ask you a question. What is the difference between running on a treadmill and running on a track? Is it the same or is it different?
Different.
What is the difference?
It will keep you where you are on the next.
Alright, that's a very interesting thing. So if you run on a track, you have a point A, you can start from point A and reach point B. Whereas if you run on a treadmill, how much of a fast you're running, you're going to stay back there. Right? Yesterday, Mac made a wonderful presentation talking about 102,000 plus members were added last year in BNI world. Out of that, if you really look at the net add of only 17,100, what does it actually communicate to all of us? We are actually having a lot of members getting out of the BNI system. So, it's something like this, how much of a fast you run, you see suddenly, you see like you add a lot of, in your evening, there's a lot of wonderful visitor orientation, you have a mega visitor day, you have so many people coming into different chapters, and your admin team, your chapter leadership team comes and tells you, hey, we've added this many number of people. How do you feel? Do you feel good? You feel great. Again, another call comes and says, we have lost this many number of people. Is that a good news? Hello?
No.
It's not a good news, right? One way you will get all the additions to the chapter. The other area, you will feel that you lost few members. So, it's very, very difficult to hear those number news, as well as how do we really maintain the momentum going is another big challenge. So it's very, very important to understand when we have about 80% retention, I also could empathize with some of the regions where the lesser number of retention, the kind of pain that you're going through. So what we actually did in our region, we just figured out why do members join BNI. They join BNI because it's very disciplined. It's make you get up early in the morning, the rest of the people sleep, you go to a meeting, and you start thinking about business. There's a discipline, there's a structure. The second thing that people join BNI is to get more business. The third and most important thing is about relationship and network. So, what we're going to cover up in the next few minutes is about the triple E formula. But before we actually talk about the triple E formula, we wanted to actually look at one more additional formula, which is E. This particular E is all about educate, educate, educate. In our region, what we believe strongly is that as soon as a member comes into the chapter, it is something that you need to really educate them in terms of the system, how this BNI system is going to really help you and take you to the next level. So, we in our region have the culture, like Dr. Meister says, immersed in the culture of learning. So, we have this right kind of culture of making people involved in the education of BNI system right from the beginning. So, what is the kind of a culture that we're talking about here? So, retention is nothing but culture setting. So, if you have the right kind of culture in your organization, that's what we've been told to us from Murli initially. Have the right kind of culture in your region and things will fall in place. So, what exactly is culture? You have a team of people in your organization. How do they together see things? How do they together think? How do they together feel, and how do they together act? It's all about culture in a very simple terms. So, in order to have the right kind of a culture, we created certain directions. Those directions will give all the members of the region to work together as a one single team with one single team. To give you a little more direction, more information about the direction, let me invite Santhosh.
When we were there in the first international conference, we had a good fortune to have a virtual session with Philbert. So when I met Philbert, Philbert was asking me, what is the kind of direction you have? I was completely lost. And he said, for UK region, there is something called 50-50-50. Only thing what I remembered was 50, 50 and 50. I went back to Coimbatore and I said that we have to grow our rice market more higher. It should be 70-70-70. And we gave a direction to our region, 70% members in green, 70% members doing one-to-one, and 70% members giving business to other members. So that was an initiative that we start to give direction for our chapter members. And that, along with that, our members, directors came back with another 300. Okay, 100% members, 100% members have done MSP, 100% members have done their profile in BNI Connect, 100% members have done their BNI Connect, MSP, and also giving attendance for their chapter. So this was a wonderful foundation for our region. We got our foundation right. From there, we moved on to another direction called 212. When 212 came, we added one small addition to this particular number. The number what we added was to have the 90-day renewal process in time. And this was given as a direction to our region, and the region was doing all these processes wonderfully well, and we were able to get a 70% strong region with green members. And that was the first aspect that we really enjoyed as this the whole concept of direction. So thank you for that wonderful aspect called direction. And now once we have set this particular direction right, our head table came and said, boss, too many parameters to follow. It is very difficult to follow all these parameters. So what the next few years what we did was we reduced few parameters, and the next direction was good to great. From good to great, we added only one thought process. If the chapter has to be really good, they should have a compelling direction. A compelling direction can only be achieved if they have a compelling calendar. So every chapter in our region delivers a wonderful calendar, and they stick to that particular calendar. So the members have a feeling that something extra is going to come in the next month. So they start renewing more and more. And they have a hope that there are a lot of activities and which from there they could get their businesses. So from that direction to the current direction, we have gone to the triple E formula which Nassar will do.
Alright, see what actually happened when Santhosh is talking about direction. We have a management team in our region, excellent team. We have the BC, we have ambassadors, we have training team. They are amazing people, they have excellent ideas in them. So when we say these directions, this is not direction from both of us, it's from the rest of the team. So, we always believe in asking the right questions rather than giving them directions. So, it's always better to ask than tell. So, we picked up a very interesting book. Some of you would like to read about this. It's still a book called Humble Inquiry by this gentleman called Eager C. He talks about how do we make people involved or ask them the right kind of questions instead of you telling them what they want to do. So, our team came up with this wonderful idea in terms of the right kind of direction setting. As a process, what we have done here is we looked at the region's core values. There are three core values in our region. One is focus in business, second is quality, third thing is about relationship. In the focus in business, we are talking about members making more money. In the quality that we are talking about is the renewal process. The third thing that we are talking about growth, how do we really look at it in terms of the right kind of people coming into the system. And the last, in terms of relationship, we are talking about retention as well as the focused activity which will make the people come into this. As a concept of all these things, if you want to really take the trigger from one direction to the next direction, keep the momentum going, take the needle from one to the next, our team came up with this powerful, three powerful words. One is called expectation, the second one is called experience, and the third one is called excellence. So the three formula that we're trying to talk about, the triple E formula, is expectations, experience, and excellence. Every question goes to take us through the expectation aspect of it.
As Nassar said, we would like you to understand this particular word called grit. The grit is nothing but grow your chapter as a power team. Your application to the process should be due diligence. And you should have a lot of excitement on the new member onboarding process. You should have a wonderful education system for the new member who believe that BNI system will work for them. And finally, track and touch points, the reward and recognition for the new members so that their expectations are very right. I will get you to every slide, grow your chapter. Luckily, when we are being forced by right leaders, they told you have to run a wonderful meeting and you have to select members from them. So what we heard was this word called selection. So when we have to select, normally whether we have power team or not, we went back to our members and asked, who are the members that we want to be part of this particular chapter? So the members decided that these are the members that they wanted to be part of BNI. And that was our biggest success from the day one. Members gave us a list saying that these are the members we would like to be part of our chapter. And that one small activity made our region much more stronger, because it is not EDs or directors who are adding members to the region, it is the members who are adding members to their chapter. So that is one great thing. And what I learned in one of my support training was one member from Surat whose chapter size is 150. Difference chapter size is 150. That member is standing up and saying, I have a 96 member open category list. 96 member open category list. A chapter with 150 members have a 96 member open category list. It's a huge learning session for all of us, because the MC committee doesn't have any challenges. The MC has only one thing, because they know what is the category they have to add. So if you have open category list, it is something, a clarity for the MC to do their work much more happier. And most importantly, we know that our members find our customers. Our members find our customers. So what is in it for them? What is in it for them? And they should be happy if they are adding new members. So this is what we say, grow your chakras, power chakras, power team chakras. That is why BNI Kanpur enjoys another successful two chapters, one chapter on industry and one chapter on agriculture. The next is our application process. Our application process is very, very simple. We are telling all our MC committee members, we are not dealing with categories, we are dealing with people. We are not dealing with categories, we are dealing with people. So they go with this kind of a mindset and they educate a new member, is it okay for you to collaborate and work? Is it okay for you to collaborate and work? You are a specialist in this particular category. Before we collect their check, we check with them, are they ready to collaborate? And are they ready to be part of this specialized category? And we check their website, we check their brochures, we check their visiting cards to ensure that they are not actually competing some of the members of our region. Because we want to be ensuring that our members who are given check, we should protect their interest. So this is something that we strongly believe on, because we have to add value for our members who have given our check. So this benefit has helped our new members to understand what is category and how to be part of this particular category specialist. So this is our process on review application. And how many of you have seen a trailer and you have said the trailer is very bad? Movie trailer. All the movie trailers are good, yes or no?
Yes.
Maybe the feeling might be bad. So we tell our new members, you are joining process to be like a trailer. It should give a lot of excitement. So we ask our new members to take their family members. We will ask our new members to bring their customers, friends, relatives, everybody to be part of this joining session. We launch, when they are getting inducted, we wanted every one of their family to be there. One best benefit of this particular session is, after the induction ceremony is over, the meeting is over, the members' father will stand and say, thank you, my dear. I'm very happy my son has joined in a wonderful forum. The client will come and say, like, bro, I'm very happy my customer is there and said a wonderful forum, and we want to give this to our members. So these are kind of emotions that we get when you have a wonderful activity. And even now what's been happening is a lot of new members are sponsoring new members in our region. So this excitement is always there in the voting process. And we also track all these things in one of our concepts called Garam Diary. We give a diary to our members, and this particular diary to our MC team, and the MC team makes sure that everything is being documented. This is again one of the exercises what we did was, once I went and sent for the MC meeting long back, around 4.5 years back, everybody was talking about problem. I was really bummed. 45 minutes they were only talking about problem. So I said, like, how could I avoid this? So I gave them this particular concept for Garam Diary, and they said, I wanted you to write all these things. So they write the application process, they write the mentoring process. So now 45 minutes they will only talk about BNI, 5 minutes they will talk about the problem and they leave off. So this was giving us a wonderful benefit. So we ensure that our members are being educated properly, how to bring 40 cards, how to bring 40 invitation letters. Everything is being educated, somebody is delegated, and everything is being planned out. And once we do this, we also celebrate the new member in our LDRT. We track their celebration with how many visitors they have brought in. We call them as unsung heroes. We call them as unsung heroes. We ask them to be part of our system, and we tell the whole crowd, these are the new members who have created so much of energy for our region. And this particular activity has built more energy and sustained new members for our region, so we don't have enough time on the third one they will leave. Because the members have been appreciated, the members have been tracked down, and we are talking very good about their new members. So this is our great process.
What Santhosh just told us is that in our region, retention actually begins from the day a member joins the chapter. It is not something that at the end of the term, you start looking and scratching your head and looking at, okay, another 2 months down the line, this guy is going to leave. How are we going to retain? So the whole process starts from the day a member becomes part of the BNI system. Now that the greeting process is done, the expectations are set. Now what is the next thing that we are looking at? We are taking them from that level to the next level. So what kind of experience are they can have in the company? So I'm sure all of you are here with this experience. Anybody who comes into the company, the first 100 days are very, very important. There's a very beautiful book by the name, The First 100 Days. So any CEO comes in, anybody who comes into the organization, everybody looks at them, what if this guy is going to do something? So the same thing applicable for the BNI system as well. So this experience of taking them from one level to next level is very, very important. So what I'm going to share with you right now is about experience. In this experience, I'm going to use this word called engage. You remember, I told you, the first one that you need to remember is about greeting, the second is about engaging. In engaging, what I'm going to talk to you about, what kind of expectation that we can set? What kind of wider network did these guys have in the region, and of course, across the country? What kind of a personalized BNI connect? How do you put your games profile in the BNI connect in the right way? Then we're talking about what kind of a momentum that you can build in your chapter. How can you really accelerate so that the people are part of the system? Then we're talking about generating new customers every single term. Then we're finally looking at what kind of a relationship that you can embrace to the fellow members in your organization, the respective members, business organizations. So I'm going to spend some time in terms of taking you a little more detailed into it. First thing that we're going to ask about somebody who comes into part of the BNI membership is that, what kind of business are you expecting? What kind of a dream referral you're looking at? Who exactly is your customer? Where is he? What kind of a business are you looking at? How does he buy? Where does he buy? When does he buy? How much does he buy? How long does he buy? And things of that sort. So really look at who exactly is your customer. Once the customer definition is done, then you start asking them what kind of referral value they're looking at. What is the big ticket value that they have? What kind of a target do they have? If they have to be happy, if they have to be really, really be successful in terms of being part of this wonderful system for BNI, what kind of business are you looking at? What is the kind of an average referral they're looking at on a week-on-week basis? So based on this, we look at creating the right kind of expectation from them, understanding the expectation of this person. And then, of course, we also tell them what kind of a deliverable that we can have from our system, the chapter, as well as the rest of the team. Now, we also look at something more beyond that. Not everybody comes into BNI just for the sake of business. Okay? There are some company members in our region, they are second-generation business owners. That means the father has established a very good business, they are running successful business, they have huge amount of volume running in terms of business, in terms of volume of business and size. So why do these guys come into business? Because they are known in the city as so-and-so's son. They are not known in the city as so-and-so as an individual person. So these guys come there in order to get some kind of recognition for them. So they don't look at business, but they look at more of importance to them. So we look at, okay, this is another reason that why people are coming. So we try to create the right kind of expectation of the people. Then we take them to the next thing. So what we talk about the network is here, okay, there is this particular guy who has a business. In case if you don't get a business, we tell them, why don't you just come on to the business? All the new members every single month, we invite them to the LGRT and DCRT. In the LGRT, we have this bigger picture. Our region has got a bigger goal. What is our goal? BNI in the region should be the number one go-to organization to build your business. If you want to grow your business, if you are an SME, if you are an entrepreneur, you don't have any other option to go anywhere else but to BNI. So that is the number one organization, go-to organization. We are looking at close to about 2,000 business owners in our region and touching some 50,000 lives, 50,000 people, touching them in terms of vendors, suppliers, and things like that. And average, each member makes a business of 1 crore rupee in Indian terms. In the dollar terms, it's about $140,000. What we have given in the slide, $10 million per member, is actually not $10 million. It's a mistake. It is 10 million rupee. In dollar terms, about $140,000. So that's the kind of average business we're looking at. So when you saw this bigger picture, and as a team member, I walked into the DS, LTRT, and look at all the other people talking about, there is a bigger picture for you. It's not just the chapter. The whole region is working for you to get more business. And we also take them to the dashboard. So about 3-4 months back, we have the dashboard. So you look at, there is a bigger picture, and every single month, we track that. There is a dashboard that tells you the number of referrals, the retention percentage, the region that we have, the net promoter score that we are having, all those data dashboard is there in front of you. When a new member looks at it, he feels confident. It's not that my chapter is alone helping me, the entire region is helping me, the rest of the people are actually working towards a common goal. In our region, a few years back, when we started looking at, Coimbatore is a place, it's not many of you know, some of you know, it's actually an obvious, it's a place where a lot of entrepreneurs live. All the cars that you're driving, there will be some part of that, your car that you're driving, there will be a part which is manufactured in the city. So they look out for exports, they look out for connecting to cross-border businesses and things like that. In that particular profile, so what we looked in our region long back, we came up with this idea, local business, regional business, international business, and of course to the global business. So in that particular process, if that has to happen, your profile has to be visible. So if that profile has to be visible, you have this wonderful platform called BNI Connect. How are you putting your profile in the BNI Connect? That's what Santhosh was talking sometime back, 100% on BNI Connect. So that particular presence in the BNI Connect is something which we give a lot of importance to. Okay, as you all know, if you want to grow something, you need to create momentum. If you want to create momentum, what you need to do? You need to have a compelling reason to go and start your working. So what we do in a chapter, we have something called an accelerator. What is an accelerator? A powerful tool in BNI system starters is a calendar of terms. The 6 months the leadership teams are working, they have a very clear-cut calendar. In that particular calendar, what you need to do? You have something to do. So as a new member, I go to the chapter, I'm not very excited about it, but I look at something over, there's going to be a big visitor day coming. So far, I did not get any business. But there's a visitor day coming in. Possibly, I may get some business. Okay? And these events will keep your members to momentum, keep going. And that will be a great accelerator. And finally, every single term, the leadership teams always feel so pride about they have achieved some milestone. One of the things that we talk about in our region is that every single member, at the towards the end of the term, he stands up and tells you, these are the new members that I have added because of BNI. These are the new referrals that we've got because of BNI. When this comes and every single member in the chapter keeps talking about it, it's such a pride in each one of the members and of course the rest of the people because they have added the teaching of the new customers and the respective members to a large size. So that is something which we look at it. And finally, embracing relationship. What is this embracing relationship is all about? See, enthusiasm is contagious, you all know. If I'm getting excited, I'll ensure the other people all around me is also getting excited. How do we pass on this happiness from one to next and things like that? So if that has happened, all you need to do is to ensure that the people in your organization, people at home, also get excited. In that particular process, we just wanted to show you a small video about how chapter members are making the rest of the people happy. I'm happy. direct question for that. So what I wanted to take you through from Santhosh is the next E that we're talking about. How can you make your member to excel them to the next year?
The one point that I would definitely love to take, one thing which is giving us a lot of great results is that small testimonial that our members give to our LKM. What Nassar said, like generating new customer list. Every member stands and says, these are new customers. When they say this new customer testimonial to the LKM, that gives a lot of positive emotion and members renew. And because BNI is all about new customers. And when this kind of momentum has been built on, we want to keep this momentum on and on. And we have this formula called money. Money is all nothing but meaningful connections, overwhelming experiences, nurturing leaders and expanding horizons, empowering businesses and enriching relationship, you, your BNI chapter and your BNI tribe. In this, when we talk about meaningful connections, our activities are something like Doctor's Day, cross-region one-to-one, blood donation camp, sports day, parents day, all these things, activities have a lot of connections. And if you have a lot of visitors coming to your chapter and your chapter is not making money, that is wrong. Like you do business and you are not making profit, that is wrong. Likewise, when you have a wonderful activity, your members should make money. So all these activities or meaningful connections has to be resulted in money. And every head of the member is proud enough to come and tell back, like when you do this kind of activity, this is the money that our chapter has got. And this gives an excellence, and this gives a continuity to our members, showing that when we do new activities, meaningful connections have been established. And when meaningful connections have been established, you get a lot of money. The next is, from the local, we want that from time to time, I can give a promise like our members have visited various countries. Whenever they go to various countries, they come back and say, wow, there is as equal there. So they have a very positive mind frame saying that when you go there, the members ask, how can I help you? So are we using this wonderful platform to ask our members or educate our members to go break borders and grow and do a lot of businesses? And we have seen in all our 13 chapters, our members have traveled widely across various regions, and we have put our heart and say thank you to all the members of all the national heads, all the executive directors who have embraced all the members who are coming to their region and given them an opportunity to do business in their region. So that is giving them a wonderful experience. The next is we have a wonderful team. When you have to deliver something very big, you should have great leaders. And we have leaders like Nassar, a great team of team members in our region who educates and coaches a lot of leaders. Use our training programs. All our training programs are 90% or 100% full, and we have full room of leaders. We educate them, we tell them this is an opportunity to build relationships and take up roles and build more businesses. So we nurture leaders to expand their horizons. Let's just we also talk about more on relationship. This is a small 30-second video how a member feels about his business and growth.
This is Ramesh from AES Technologies Media. I have been a member of BNI Excellence Fund Group for the past 3 years under the category of Dubai Arts Award. I have received several targeted referrals for my business from my fellow members every week, and able to achieve close to $250,000 from one single referral. The project has been done for a hospital in India. Now I have obtained this as a product and selling to other hospitals and achieved 10 more hospitals. My business has been empowered by enriching my relationship with my fellow members. Thank you.
So we ask members, it is your also accountability to be part of the system continuously. If they leave on the first year or second year, we are losing our relationship. That's all?
Yes.
So we want our members to get skipped on. If you are there on the third year, if you are there on the fourth year, if you are there on the fifth year, we are enriching our relationship. And if we are enriching our relationship, we are actually enriching our businesses. If we are moving around, if our churn rates are very high, it is very difficult for us to sustain this relationship and business. So we request our members as an accountability part, be part of our accountability, empower relationship and enrich relationship and also empower businesses. This is something very, very close, because when we do all these things, this is the end benefit. You can see a wonderful video of a small chapter which talks about.
Hi friends, it's my pleasure to be with you on this momentous day.
and I'm going to take you through an interesting journey. It was on the 24th of June 2014 that a new star was born in the BNI galaxy, a new chapter called BNI Excellence, a chapter that would redefine BNI in every way. Teamwork and participation have been the hallmarks of this particular chapter.
Excellence is the wow chapter meaning. Excellence, I mean, exceed expectations. Excellence is one big family which thinks big. Dream more than what others think is practical. Excel more than what others think is possible. Dream and excel, only at excellence.
Excellence is a platform for brilliant opportunities.
Three simple words, sum up our chapter. Expertise, experience and excellence.
Excellence is all about attitude, attitude and attitude. Everything about excellence is simply awesome.
Excellence is just simply giving your best in everything you do.
Excellence is all about taking business to the next level.
Excellence is for innovative entrepreneurship.
Excellence, where every new member is mentored to be at home.
Excellence is a progress of thinking.
Excellence is not a skill, it is an attitude.
Excellence is about setting standards month on month.
Excellence is really entertaining.
Excellence has changed my business outlook completely.
Excellence, here I created a chumma adrudilla.
Follow excellence. Success will just follow you.
As you just witnessed, excellence is teamwork at its best. Every single member is an asset and enriches a chapter by participating in a big way.
Excellence is about empowering businesses and enriching relationships, not just for our members, but for our visitors as well. You too can experience excellence. You are welcome to join us at our meetings. Till then, on behalf of Team Excellence, I wish you good luck. And thank you very much for your time. See you.
So this is what we do, like, you know, all our members have this kind of a pride that they belong to an organization which has the philosophy of Giver's Gate. Engaged members get the bigger picture and they are passionate and they are proud and to be associated with BNI and their region. And that is the reason for the last 5 years, on a continuous road, our region has got 80% plus retention. Not even 1 year we have gone down on less than 80%. It is something like, if you have that pride, your members will join and we renew again. And we always have a lot of pride in saying that we are too good in ordinary operation. Thank you for all our mentors who made us do this thing 100% right, you will get wonderful results. So we have got this extraordinary opportunity because we are good in ordinary operations.
My dear friends, I started off asking you with one particular thing. I also started telling that if we don't give attention to retention, we will all be in
tension.
I want all of you to please repeat after me. If we don't give attention to retention, we'll all be in
tension.
So, what we are trying to tell you here is that the retention activity starts from the beginning. For that, you need to give this 3E formula, which is expectations, experience, and then excellence. And I also told you to remember those 3 words, greed, engage, and money. If you start focusing on all these 3 things, you will inculcate a great attitude in every single member and they will start feeling it's my chapter, my pride. I want to thank all the BNI One India family, the executive directors across the country. We picked up a lot of things from them. They shared a lot of ideas for us in terms of how do we make sure that works in our system. I also wanted to share with you some of the nearby regions in our place, Salem, Tirunelveli, Trichy, Pondicherry. All these regions have kind of, we have shared this information with them and they already started implementing it and they have kind of mastered it for us and they also maintain close to about 80 plus retention right now. So, I'm sure this is the experience that I want to leave you with, is that a member when they join the chapter, it is our responsibility to make them get what they wanted to get out of the chapter. Thank you very much.
Thank you.